Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Optimizer. So in this video we are going to start with one more design, that is bearing design. So if you just take a close look on this design, if you just see, this is axis symmetric about this vertical axis. Okay, so whatever component we have seen up till now, that is related to pad and pocket. So in this design part, bearing design, we are going to discuss shaft command. Okay, so if you just see this cross section, whatever cross section you are hash cross section is there, this is symmetric about this axis. So we need to use shaft command in that case. Okay, so what we need to draw first, we need to draw this section, this cross section like this. Okay, and then that cross section you need to rotate about this vertical axis. Okay, so this is 360 rotation you need to do, and after that whatever the holes, fillets are there, these holes, fillets are there, that you need to draw. Okay, so let us start. So for that I am going to select this ZX plane as a working plane. So go to Sketcher, select this ZX plane. So here how many number of steps required? We required only 3 steps. First one is this shaft, second one is this pocket, and third one is whatever the fillets are there that we need to draw. Okay, so whenever the cross section is symmetric about the any axis, then we need to use shaft command. Okay, so let us start. You need to draw one profile, simple profile, which is like this. Okay, now if you just go through this, this total height is 0.75, this width is 0.75, and total height is 2.12, and this total diameter is 5.5. okay, so this dimension we need to give, and this hole, internal hole, let us check that one. The width is 0.75, this is continuous, so this is 2.76. okay, so from this to this it is very small only, so just drag these lines right now only, so that there is no, the diameter is 5.50, diameter is 5.50, so 5.5 divided by 2. You can take a scale also for such kind of things, otherwise we will draw as it is of this one. So I am going to just orient this. Total height, if you just see, total height is 0.75 of this one, this is 0.75, and from this to this it is 2.12. So from this axis, this height is 2.12. Now just see. Okay, so we'll bring this dimension closer to the sketch. So just you need to press left click, and just you need to drag like this one. Okay, now so this is our what we can say geometry. So again some dimensions are missing. So from this to this it is actually 2.76 divided by 2, something we have 2.76 divided by 2. Okay, so I have given this diameter. Okay, and again this one is 0.75, so this is 0.75. okay, so now this is totally fully constrained actually. 0.75, this diameter is 0.75. So let us check. So we have just missed, this is not 0.75, so this internal diameter is given. So just see, this internal diameter is given, it is around 1.5. okay, so you can define this as 1.5. so from this to this it is diameter is 1.5, that is you can define as 0.75. okay, so this is how we have completed this first step. Now you have to rotate it about this vertical axis. So just exit workbench, click on the shaft command, and here you need to select two things. First one is axis, that is by default selected, and right click you need to select rotation axis. So here the vertical axis is z axis, so you just right click on this no selection, and from this you need to select z axis. Okay, so once you click on z axis, total body will be rotated, and just click on OK. Okay, so this is somewhat what we can say, hardware problem, that's why it is not seeing circular, as the dimensions are very small. And now there is holes, that is around 0.12 radius, so 0.5 mm radius holes are there. So we are going to draw one hole here, and that we are going to use a pattern command, and we are going to make it is 0.5, and this is at 4.24 PCM, that is from this axis it is, this one is 4.21 divided by 2. Okay, 4.24, it is 4.24 divided by 2. Okay, so we have drawn one hole. As the dimensions is very small, that's why it is exactly, it is not seeing like a circular body, but actually it is like that only. Now we are going to pocket that up to next. So we have just created one pocket. Okay, and just see, I have created one pocket. Now these holes are equidistant about this one. Again, you can use a circular pattern command then. So just go here, select this circular pattern. Okay, so what we want to pattern, so we want to pattern this pocket only. So you need to select this pocket, and how many instances we required, we require 4 instances, and here you need to select complete crown. Okay, complete crown mean in 360 4 instances will be created. Okay, now again rotation axis you need to select. Rotation axis we know that is this is z axis, so click on z axis and just click on OK. Okay, so 4 holes are automatically created. And now last step is you need to provide a fillet. So fillets are around 0.12 radius. Okay, 0.12 mm radius. So you can give fillet, that is go to fillet, here we can define as 0.12, correct? So wherever the fillets are there, you can apply same fillet. For example, here it is also 0.12 mm, yeah, up to this here also same fillet is there. So if you want to see a smooth transition, we have discussed in last video, so you just activate this option. So this is how bearing is. So this is not captured as it is, because dimensions are very small, that's why it is seeing like some straight lines. Okay, I hope you understood this video. If you like this, please subscribe our channel and stay tuned for more videos. Thank you, we'll stop here.